Good evening, students. This is Dr. Shubhi, and today we will learn freeze in MS Excel. Now, you all know we are learning data management techniques and tools in MS Excel and how to handle large and huge data when we are working for some kind of research or any particular issue that we are trying to understand. Now, let's take this particular sheet where you can see there are a lot of marks and lot of records are there. First, I'll take you to the entire sheet and you can see how many rows are there. So you can see these are the rows and these are the marks of students. I've put some garbage data for you just to understand that how the data is created. You all can see this header, name, class, roll number and marks in some subjects like BRM, MIS, Hindi, French, Excel, followed by total, percent, grade, re-exam status and mark sheet given or not. So this is our header. Likewise, these are the name of the students AB, AB. They are the students of, let's say, class PGDM, postgraduate diploma in management, and their roll numbers are PG1, PG2, PG3. So this is our data. So now the problem is that we are not doing any computation on the data, but we are trying to view the data, how to understand the data. So what we will do, first of all, we will learn what is freeze. There is something called as freeze column. Now suppose I want to scroll on the screen. Now the problem is that when I go on the next column, the names are gone. I am not able to see if I am scrolling in the columns, I cannot see the names. So what I have to do, again I have to come back to the name, which is a very tedious task because scrolling information across the sheet is a huge task and I'm not able to finalize, I'm not able to understand whose value is this, then it becomes a big issue. So now what is the solution? Solution is you select this column and you go to view tab. I again repeat, you select this column, whichever, suppose this is your column, and you go to the view tab. You all can see the options home, insert, page layout, formula, data review and view. So in the view there is an option called as freeze panes. Here you can see freeze first column. Freeze first column means I'm trying to freeze this particular column. And now no matter I scroll my cursor over the sheet, you will find that the column is fixed. So for the name you can see the percent, for the name you can see the grade, re-exam status and mark sheet given or not. So what I have done, I have fixed my column. Similarly, I can also fix the row. I select the rows, I go to freeze pane. First of all, I unfreeze whatever I have frozen and then freeze top row. So now in this case the top row has this heading. So what I will do, I will go to freeze panes. I'm unfreezing it and since there are multiple rows, I'll go to freeze panes and I'll go freeze pane. So in freeze pane you can see many rows are there. If rows are multiple, I can delete few rows and I can see that my particular row comes into that on that status. Now you all can see over here that the name and class are frozen and I am scrolling my data. Name and class are frozen and I am scrolling the data. Now suppose I want this particular header also to be on the in the frozen part, so I'll do like this. Now you all can see a line and now this is my row and I start scrolling. So you can see PG 5, 6 and the headers are fixed. Simultaneously, I have frozen the row as well as the column. And likewise, suppose I want to see the marks or the status of a particular student, I'm scrolling in the columns as well. So this is about freeze. If I don't want it, I can go for unfreeze panes and my data again comes into the shape the way it was. I can do little bit of undo, and bring all my things, all my stuff back, because whatever I've done, I can always bring back with the help of undo. And I can see my data. This is one way. Another way of viewing the data is when we can very easily zoom into the data. This can be done very easily if I am trying to zoom. You can see 100% zoom selection. From zoom selection, you can find out how you want to see it. And I can go back to zoom and it is 400%. I want to see view on 50%. I can view like this. So I'm going on zoom and I'm selecting the persons over here, 75% or 100% or 200, and I'm clicking on OK. So that is how also I can rearrange my sheet as per my requirement and increase and decrease the size of my data. One thing I want to make you very clear, that when we zoom the data, this doesn't mean that I'm increasing the font size. I'm just using a magnifying glass to view the data. It is like I'm using a magnifying glass and I'm trying to have a closer look of the data so that it is not strenuous on my eyes. Otherwise, when it comes to printing, the font size remains the same. I'm also going to fit to selection and OK. So whatever I have selected, that data will be shown. So like this, you can play with this software and you will find that Excel is extremely easy software as far as data management is concerned. The only thing is that we should know what are the meanings of those particular features which are available in these tabs. So this is Dr. Shubhi logging out from YouTube, and I'll be back with one or two more features, very good features of Excel soon. So stay tuned to Shubhi Lal on YouTube. Good night.